Okay, so I'm pretty frustrated right now. I tried to get a Rogue 2 Total War going, but it is not working out. It keeps crashing after I press and turn on the first turn. So I have to go back and try it with other factions. I tried Parthian, but I might have to just go do Rogue and see if that works. Anyway, so I'm gonna try a Total War Warhammer campaign. I played with all the factions so far, so I'm familiar, but I'll give you guys the rundown if you're a new person. So I'm going to campaign, go to a new campaign. The old world, I don't have an eye for an eye or the Season of Revelations. I haven't bought the Wood Elves yet or the Chaos Priests. So the old world. As you can see, I have, these are all the factions, Empire, Dwarves, Bretonnia, Bordello, Carcassonne, Greenskin, Blight, and the Bigger Party Counts, on Carcassonne. So these are the rest of them. I played with Empire, I played with Dwarves, I played with Carcassonne, these are all Bretonnians. I played with Greenskins, not the Blight, so I played with the Von Carcassonne instead of Vampire Counts. I really like the undead, but they don't have any ranged units, so that's for me sort of like a negative. Empire is really good ranged units. Dwarves do too. Greenskins, I think, have like sort of the weakest, but they have like a variety of like other units that support them pretty well. So I think maybe the dwarves of Bretonnia. Grudges. I want to play with dwarves again. They're pretty cool. They're really good against just pretty much every single race. That's why initial challenge is easy, but
Send me to
this
vengeance.
very hard. This is the original one.
I
you
must
can get Umbreon
fulfill
later.
my slayer.
For the Karazhan Khan. Our enemies shall tremble.
So it says
to
construction
war.
cost minus 10%, upkeep for Longbreed Tamers minus 10%.
You know who I am.
I am the
minus
Slayer
15%
King.
For slayers and 25% minus reduction in recruitment costs.
I am the
invasion
White
when using
Dwarf.
40%. Invasion when using underway, so that's a thing I'll show you guys. That's gonna be basically they're gonna be digging under the ground and popping up somewhere else instead of marching. Reinforced range. Oh, nice. For 30% for Grombrindal's army. Can call upon the power of the ancestral gods. I have no idea what that's about. So I'm gonna start with Grombrindal.
The old world is a crucible of relentless war. It has ever been so. An era as long as the mountains are unyielding. The storms gather again. It presents a chance for the brave to bring about an age of reckoning. I come to the Dwarf High King as a herald of such times. So I find myself at the King's right hand. Presence is timely, for dire news comes from the south. Greenskins flock to the banner of a cruel war boss. grim grudge-bearer, leads a mighty throng from Karazakarak, smashing aside any foes that block our path. If Grudgebearer desires to return the Karaz Angkor to its former glory, then he must rid his lands of vile greenskins. Those gathering within the shadows of Everpeak are a good start.
Ooh, interesting.
And let's say the dwarf was sleeping on the job on that gyrocopter. On a visit to Karak, the White Dwarf witnessed Thorgrim vanquish greenskins that dared skulk in the shadow of Everpeak. The orcs of the bloody spears were routed, with many sent scurrying to the pillars of Grombrindal. Whilst witnessing these events, Grombrindal had remained incognito, but at this outrage, he revealed himself to the High King, pledging to take a throng of willing Dawi and recapture the secret site. Long loading screen. Anyway, so I played with the main boss of each faction. I actually started off with Balthazar on the Empire instead of Emperor Karl Franz, so we could go through that. But actually, in the Dwarf campaign, when I played first, the as Thorgrim Grudgebearer, I couldn't play as we didn't get Grombrindal, the White Dwarf, but we could get Umgrin Iron Fist, the other one for the Slayers. That's a unit later on. So I want to see if we can get all three heroes if we get this third, if we use this third one. So that'd be something I'm trying out. That'd be pretty cool if we could get all three legendary heroes instead of just two at a time. And maybe that's the same with all the other factions as well. I play as the vampires undead, as Von Karstein. So we were Vlad and Isabella Von Karstein, but we didn't get
any. Hail to you, Grombrindal, ancestor of legend. You have secured Karazakarak, defended it from the greenskin fiends, and put their gutless horde to rout. Yet more remains undone. The bloody spears still infest the mountains to the east, setting up their hovels amidst your sacred pillars. Dwarfen lands lay sullied by their sickening taint. You must be the hero of the ancient sagas, and march for their deliverance. To the south, yet more vicious Urki and Grobi lay ready to strike at your kin. Perhaps even the loathsome Black Goblin. Know that there are other dwarfen lords who would gladly ally with one so legendary as you, for common cause. The dwarfs will know a new age of prosperity, heralded by the battle cry of Grombrindal, the White Dwarf.
Okay, so grudge issue, that's the special thing for the dwarves in Total Warhammer. Beheld by the enraged graves of Grimnir, the bloody spears have trespassed with impunity over all sacred, over the sacred mountains. Their forces gathered from the east and must be defeated before the strength is regained. Defeat an army belonging to the bloody spears and gain 1,000 gold. Okay, so quick rundown. We do have the dwarves up here. It's our treasury. This is our income. And then we have our icons. There will be more with different events. This is our book. Then, so depending on the number of grudges we have that are unfilled, this will grow more and more. So this is new for me. The living ancestor, soon you will be, we'll call him the power of the ancestor god. Sediment is up here, map is up here, this has our forces and stuff like that. We can toggle strategic over map. So Fog of War, this is what we know about. Information panel right here. This is our settlements. very hard, so our public order is going to be at a pretty bad. Anyways. I do want to get some gold going. Gem mine shaft, yes. I'm not sure if I want to upgrade these barracks yet. I'll show you guys something later. I guess I'll right now. So if I right click this button, I'll show you all the trees. Can't click the other two here. But this one doesn't require level 4 or higher settlement upgrade. So therefore I can use this on one of these areas, which means the entire province that I own gains that access to those units. So I do that, I can save this space for something else, therefore I will build it on Pillars of Rugby later on. Alright, let's go to technology. This is our other information screen. Diplomacy, grudges, there it is. Objectives, short campaign victory. We have chapter objectives right now, not any. Treasury, faction summary, just overall panel of our stuff. Diplomacy. Alright, cool.
Relations with foreign powers may be managed through diplomacy, my lord. Consider your situation carefully before accepting any agreement.
So I want to be nice and friendly with all the dwarves. So let's see if we can. You can sort by race, name, strength, and settlements by clicking these. This will go down or go reverse. Alright. So, Barak Far, we do have a trade agreement with them.
Come, kin. Let us.
We have military access. The Empire.
You approach us in difficult days.
No non-aggression pact. But we do have a non-aggression pact with the Empire. Okay, cool. Lufbar.
Welcome, Dowie. Deobrig.
Yes, very nice. So they'll be more friendly towards me.
Greetings. We may not be the Empire.
Yes. Humans. The rest of these guys, probably, I don't want to ally with orcs or greenskins in this case. Okay. Let's just fight.
No fool,
one, two, three,
for
four,
world.
Five, six units.
I'm ready.
One, two, three, four, five. I have seven. Whatever.
The battle!
Spend the units. Alright, so let's fight this battle. Quick save. Hopefully I can not fuck up in this first fight. Alright. Orc boys lack the strength of villains, but the tenacity and endurance in battle is well respected. That's the normal units of the orcs. Orc boys, orc archer boys, goblins. We have miners, special miners. We have iron drakes, nice. I didn't really check out the units. And a gyrocopters. The upgraded gyrocopters. Alright. This is the battle fight. Map, we can toggle the speed over here. I'm going to try to do everything in normal speed, but I might go to slow motion. And then maybe pause just to show off some things. Grombrindal, I'm definitely sending him into combat. Looks like he is. Have no fear, allies are unbreakable. Map wide. Very nice. That's pretty awesome. Okay. So these miners, they throw blasting charges, so they have ammunition. These guys have ammunition. These guys are archers. Alright. Good. These iron drakes, very effective. These guys will be my front line. I'll throw these guys in. So they're gonna be my left flank, this is gonna be my right flank. Grombrindal, himself's gonna be there. Drakes are there so that they can get the most out of the shooting them. So we'll start the battle. Then bring these guys up. This toggle here is gonna lock the group, so then they're all gonna attack charge instead. And then I'll have so I can turn on cinematic mode right here. These dwarves. These Iron Jason fucking freaking fire is coming out of their guns already. So these guys, these Gobcoppers have bombs. They do some explosions. I have the firing arts turned on so I can easily see. That's just gameplay preference. So I'm gonna try to. Yeah, okay. So let's move because they're within range. This is really useful, although it might be cheating, so to speak. But it's really helpful when you have lots of artillery, though. Get less casualties, basically. Let's just fast forward this. So, if you hold down the alt, you can have the melee range units mainly too. Just kill some more. About to dead enemies. Thank you. leadership, just because he's losing morale pretty easily. So I got that.
The Brubi maintain one of their slum camps beneath the pillars of Grombrindal. A sin that cannot remain in the Damask Kron any longer. The pillars must be returned to Dwarfen hands.
So I can look at the rest of their units here. They've been beat back pretty badly. They have 5 units. They're just all goblins. I don't think my forces are here for handling. There's not enough diversity. Having more archers would be nice, but I have plans. So right now I'm going to actually garrison or encamp. These will increase my replenishment. If I'm in my own province, I replenish, but this will give me more replenishment. I can also recruit units from regardless. Warriors. There we go. Alright, so the next turn I will definitely attack. Legendary Commerce. 20% from traders. So I haven't looked at his tree yet. These are all pretty awesome. Minus recruitment cost of 5. Ooh, holy shit. He can move ridiculously. But this is short, so this is really good. All forces faction wide. That is really good. Shit. Inspiring presence. Okay, so that's more leadership. I want to have him be a good fighter too, so I will invest in the full plate armor at some point. Tier 1 leadership, subterranean fights. Tier 2 melee defense. Okay, so tactician is pretty good. It says ammunition here, 3%, and it's not that good, but when you get to tier 2, you do add missile damage for the Lord's army, so for his army, so that's really good. So I'm gonna go with probably tactician, just so I can outmaneuver the enemy units. Armor piercing damage? Holy shit. Okay, well then, that's funny. Thunder, does it include Thunderers? is a rifle unit for the dwarves. Okay. I think I'm going to go with Legendary Commerce, and Ancient Acumen seems nice. I'm not sure. Recruitment cost for land units. I don't think I'll get the campaign movement range as much neededly. Global's recruitment capacity. That might be useful later on, though. We don't have a lot of stuff from trade, so that's probably not going to be useful. I'm going to give him armor. I guess I'll start. Yeah, armor, since we don't have a lot of archers units right away. So I'll give him the meat of the fight. Okay, so start with technology. A gigantic tree. It's super fucking intimidating. I'm not gonna go with fighting yet. I'm gonna go with so that's good. End of turn. That's a law. Okay, so I decided to shack up right there. So I also move this Zoof bar.
Aye, let's hear what you have to say.
Can't establish a capital. That's kind of annoying. Or trade route. I really want to start trading. I don't know how that is kind of determined. So the Greenskins are going to be down here fighting a whole bunch of stuff. There's also a faction of dwarves over here. We probably won't be able to get to them in time.
The dwarfs need me.
So we're going to normal stance, and then I'm going to attack.
Tally forward.
I'm not going to auto-resolve it, I'm just going to fight. I'm going to be super aggressive to conquer the Silver Roads as fast as possible so we get our money going. My plan is to actually go north first, just for one settlement. There's a Mount Skoonbad or something that sounds like Lord of the Rings. It gives you, there's a building you can build that gives you so much money. Like, once it's fully upgraded, it'll give you 1,800 per turn. Baseline. Okay, so let's rearrange our units. Basically, our miners are the expendable ones. Grombrindal's gonna be in front. I do want to have an opening for my Iron Drakes. So we'll move like that. That's good. So how to, so I can move them in the same formation up a little bit, just like that. And some people want to know how to rotate them. So if you hold Alt, like so, if you're moving them like that again. I'm just going to do a quick tutorial on how to do some of the things I'm doing. Lionheart X, one of the other YouTubers that does Warhammer, has a good tutorial about how this works. So, grab Alt, Control, Hold Control, and then rotate them all facing that way. I'm gonna speed this up a little bit. It's really cool. Wow, look at that. Guys up like that. Fast forward so we can get them into combat or zone quicker. I do want to try to make them come towards us.
For the ancestors!
I want my dwarves to be in range, so I'm gonna send one of my gyrocopters to harass them. Bait them towards me. Yes, and they've taken the bait. Ish, maybe. I don't know. They're just reforming. My goal is to hit all their archers at once.
Dwarf warriors! Vengeance! Charge! Castle! Yes! To the fight! I'm unstoppable! Come! Ah! Fire on the dip!
Bam! Archers are firing. then later on I'm going to do a bombing run on their archers as well, try to get them to crowd. So I'm going to shoot these archers down first. They have two units of archers. I'm going to let the miners throw their bombs. These guys attack. These guys attack. These guys attack. These guys in behind. Yes! They can't chase anymore. Alright, looks like, yeah, we're all out of units, so I'm just gonna auto up ammunition. Pyrrhic victory, very pyrrhic. I didn't expect to lose that many dwarves. but we were sort of outnumbered on units, so. We had miners, simple miners. Okay, so we've conquered this place. I don't really bother. I'm just gonna keep occupied instead of sacrificed. Gonna be killed in battle, very nice. Got another 1,000 gold, very nice. Sweet.
Your Dowie have been put to work fixing up the captured cities.
Alright, so chapter objective.
Yet there are many grudges still to settle.
More cities.
Perfidious manlings and bloodthirsty vampires threaten your kind in the north. And your mountain will never be safe while a single greenskin draws breath. To war!
So our public corps is getting worse.
Gyrocopter scouts report of a greenskin migration heading northwards. Spies say they intend to meet up and swell the mobs of the dread orc warlord who travels towards the Badlands. Whatever they are up to, they must be stopped. Summon the throng.
Okay, so we can teleport up here or we can just fight them. They have reinforcements, they have a doom diver catapult. Hate that. They have two goblin wolf fighters. The goblins are pretty easy to kill.
The dwarfs need me.
But I'm gonna actually spend my time. I'm gonna build a sparring chamber, and then so I'm basically gonna move this over here. And I'm gonna demolish this and then build something else, probably growth or a siege workshop. Probably the siege workshop. Alright.
You know who I am.
With the rest. This is turn two. So I can't build any more portal doors yet, so I'll just get more.
Agreed.
More units here. Let's see if I can do any more diplomacy.
Dowie from us.
I can't find their church agreement. Yeah. Alright. Enter. Oh, snap, crackle pop. Living ancestor, such is the age and renown of the white dwarf that many sagas say he strode with the ancestor gods themselves. It is a claim the white dwarf does not refute, and no one dares challenge, for to doubt Grombrindal's word or call him false would surely end badly for the accuser. So let's see what we can do. One legend speaks of a drinking match between Grimnir and Grombrindal. If one drunk the other under the table, it was never disclosed. All variations of the story agree that the beer stores for miles around ran dry and a strong warrior bond was formed between the two. Okay. Apprentice of Grugni. Grugni was the first dwarf to delve into a rock. So his wisdom is vast, his eye for gold and minerals unrivaled. The white dwarf can call upon his judgment. Should Grugni be in a generous mood and receive the teachings of a god. There are songs, so Prayermor of Valaya. There are songs sung of the love between Grombrindal and Valaya. Such chorales are not performed within the presence of the White Dwarf, for that would seem unseemly. For that would be unseemly. After all, Valaya was the wife of Grugni. Whatever the truth, the sagas do not doubt that the White Horse held a special place in her heart, so her protection when called upon is assured. The White Dwarf. Who is the White Dwarf? A king called Snorri, a god, a lost god, a wanderer, all of this and more. One thing is certain, where he puts his mind to something, where he deems a grudge worthy of striking from his pages, then no hell hath the fury to match the White Dwarf. So the kin of Grimnir, 25 turns. Each of these is 25 turns. Oh, very nice. Oh, nice. Melee attack, melee defense, reload time reduction, nice. Research rate increased by 20%. I'll keep my 20%. Oh, okay, that's because of construction costs minus. Oh my gosh. That is really good. Valaya. This doesn't seem too important right now. Or you can have Grombrindal, like, fuck everyone over. 20% research rate would be really nice. I wish I could see the tree to see how fast, like, it could go. I think I'm gonna be fighting a lot though, so I'm gonna get Kin of Grimir. Yeah, it's still not gonna change this too much. So it's still gonna be the same amount of turns, so the research rate isn't gonna be too much of a factor. So like, say 4 turns, if research rate was 200%, then it'd be down to 2 turns. So in 5 turns, it'd be down to 2, and it'd still be 3 turns. So I don't think that's too much of a factor. Okay, so this is almost done. Get more money. I can't get Quarrelers until this is level 2. So right now, I won't be able to get Quarrelers for a while. So I'll turn on the Barley Fields.
How can I help?
And raise.
Our enemies shall tremble. I'm ready.
I guess that's all we can do. Yeah. Level him up. So this is really good against the Ancestral Tribes, but... or the Greenskins. I think he should be better off not getting hit so much, as this is only against Greenskins. I'll be fighting more than just them. Alright, so let us continue this turn. And then next turn, I will go and conquer Mount Swigmore. Already? Alright. Oh, so I can... oh, this can do that too. Get that for now. So 15% more income from settlements. I don't have any Twinkers right now. Oh yeah, I'll definitely get this level 2. Get some more money. Throw some more.
I am the White Dwarf.
So I'm not gonna bother.
Run 'em.
I don't think we'll need to fight this one.
Fight!
We can just auto-resolve. We have a whole bunch of dwarves. And we're gonna win. Nine dwarves lost. We're gonna occupy this again.
Don't you threat, it's done.
So we've secured the Silver Road. We can now issue commandment. I'm just gonna increase money. So I kinda actually want Public Order to go really deep into the... hit 100, negative 100, so that we have units to fight. So now that we've occupied that, experience. I think we'll need, I'm gonna start getting this now. So then any other units I come up will be awesome. Since he conquered this place, I won't be able to fight. But yes, we can do trick and murder. Okay, good, good, good. I'm actually gonna try in this episode just to finish that first quest as well. So I'm gonna do one more turn. I'm gonna go merge. match.
It is
yes,
time.
Okay, and then combine.
Yes.
I'm not gonna waste that much more money. All right, so. I got this guy's over here.
Wearing ready.
I'm here now.
I think these guys are gonna hit me as soon as I leave. Dragon Helm though, that is pretty nice. And we'll get a runesmith out of it, one of our agents. So reinforcements expected. Two units of options. I'm gonna go.
Who I am.
Go and do it. So I will use 500 gold to teleport. So this is just
gonna
step outside for a bit.
I am the White Dwarf.
And then 500 gold to teleport. So I am gonna teleport him. Fight. Quick save this. So I have a banner. So I can give speed to definitely the Iron Tricks. They need to get positioned faster. They are slow as fudge. Okay. It looks like we're gonna win. They have reinforcements now. Speech apparently. Goblins have us surrounded. Fend off their impending ambush. So it sounds like they're going to be attacking from behind. I'll have guys behind protecting the corollers and the Iron Drakes. So I'll have over here.
For the High King.
These guys can be the right side covering
the corollers.
These guys are going to be protecting the backflank with these units. I'll bring them in for support. They are vanguards, so I could deploy them somewhere, but I think they'll just get screwed over first. Alright, good. Snap, grab a bomb. They're to the right. So we knew where they were, so that should be fine. So I'm gonna bring these guys to cover. Okay, these guys are too far forward, apparently. I don't know why they're there. So Goblin Wolf Riders.
Yes, sir!
looks like we have reinforcements. Hey, come back, pull back. Units have to be sacrificed. Enemy Lord is dead, that's very nice. We gotta kill him. Alright, cool. Save that. Okay, quest complete. We had these guys with gyro bombers and gyro copters. Very nice, very nice. I'm gonna release these guys so I can get just extra gold. I won't get really any penalties, I don't think.
I'm ready. I'm leaving.
Okay, so we have a runesmith over here. So runesmith breakdown. He has good reduction in corruption. Right now we don't have to deal with that. Not until we deal with the vampires up north. these runes seems really good in fighting. So I think I'm gonna try to meta up in here. Give me a second here.
You know who I am.
Just get ready for the. Oh, yes. Upgrade. I would like to upgrade you. So we'll end it right here. That is almost an hour of recording time, but let me see what I guess if anyone is interested, you can try to see me do another start another Total War series.